vector multiplication is of two types. The first type is called scalar or dot product. I hope you can hear me now.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The moment you connect, please note whether someone has muted. You will be able to see. If you see someone has muted me, then you please take it on yourself to unmute me, because I cannot see that type of screen. Okay. So what is scalar or dot product? You have a vector A and you have a vector B, and the angle between the two vectors is theta. And dot product is defined like this: A dot B equal to C, where C is the scalar. So this is called the scalar product, because the result is a scalar. It is no longer a vector. By definition, mathematically, A dot B equal to the product of the magnitudes of the two vectors multiplied by the cosine of the angle between the two vectors. Okay? So obviously, it follows that if the angle between the two vectors is zero, that is, if the two vectors are parallel to each other, we know that cos zero is one. So that A dot B equal to A into B, product of the magnitudes of A and B. Okay. On the other hand, if the two vectors are perpendicular to each other, that is, if theta is equal to pi by 2, then A dot B equal to 0, because cos theta is, cos pi by 2 is 0, cos 90 is 0. So, if you are asked, if you are given two vectors and asked to find out whether the two vectors are parallel to each other or perpendicular to each other, you simply take their dot product. If you see the result is 0, you say the two vectors are parallel to each other. If you get the result as 0, if you get the result as the product of the magnitudes, you know that the vectors are parallel to each other. If you get the result as 0, you know that the vectors are perpendicular to each other. So, if you take the dot product of a vector with the unit vector along the x-axis, then according to this definition, you get AI cos alpha, which is nothing, because I is 1, magnitude of I is 1, so this is basically A cos alpha, which according to the definition of direction cosine is A, alright? Then you have A dot J, which will give you AY, and A dot K, which will give you AZ, okay? So, the projection of a vector onto a coordinate axis gives its Cartesian component along that axis. So now it becomes very easy to find the formula of the dot product in the component form. How? So A dot B is, you write down the component form of B. Okay? So this is A dot Bx x cap plus Byy y cap plus Bz z cap. Now Bx, By and Bz are the scalar numbers coefficient, so you can take them out. So we get Bx A dot x cap, By A dot y cap plus Bz A dot z cap. But we know that A dot x cap is Ax, A dot y cap is Ay, and A dot z cap is Az. Right? So this comes out to be Bx A plus By Ay plus Bz Az. So in the component form, the dot product of two vectors is simply the sum of the product of the individual components. So if you are given two vectors and you are asked to find the dot product, you simply multiply the components and add them together, and you get the dot product. All right? So these are the two formulas that you need to remember if you are asked to find the dot product. This is the geometrical representation formula, and this is the component representation formula. Note that x dot x cap is 1, y dot y cap is 1, and z cap dot z cap is also equal to 1, because obviously they are all, the angle between them is 0. On the other hand, since they are, the axes are perpendicular to each other, so x cap dot y cap equal to x cap dot z cap equal to y cap dot z cap equal to 0. Okay? Now, for example, work done is f dot x. Force rocket with displacement. So if the direction of force and displacement of the body are the same, then the work done is maximum. You already know this from your mechanics knowledge. If the direction of force and displacement of the body are perpendicular to each other, then the work done is zero. You know, these are called no work forces. Again, for example, normal surface. What are the applications of it? So one example. Someone is on an island. I know why. Can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Hang on. Okay, so we are talking about a vector in the xy plane, which we call r, the position vector. Okay, and this is the x axis, this is the y axis. So if we have a vector n cap, this is a unit vector, and if n cap dot r equal to 0 for all values of r, then we say n cap is a perpendicular or a normal to the xy plane. Okay. So this is how we define the normal to a surface. All right. If you take the dot product of the given vector, the position vector, and if it sums out to 0 for all values of x and y, then you can say that n cap is perpendicular to the xy plane. Similarly, if you take a vector in the yz plane, then you can find out the normal by taking the dot product with the vector in the yz plane, and so on and so forth. Okay, so this is how you find out the normal to a plane. The other product is cross product, and this will be our last topic of discussion today. Vector product or cross product. So the first kind of vector multiplication is dot product, and the second kind of vector multiplication is cross product. Dot product was a scalar. Cross product is a vector. Okay, so this is how we represent cross product. A cross B equal to C, where C is a vector. So a vector which is assigned a direction perpendicular to the plane of A and B. So A, B, and C will form our right-handed system. So if you have a vector A and a vector B, and the angle between them is theta, then in geometric representation, A cross B magnitude is given by product of A and B magnitude and sine of the angle or magnitude of A cross B. So obviously, x cap cross x cap equal to y cap equal to z cap cross z cap equal to 0, because if theta is 0, we know sine theta is, sine 0 is 0. So if two vectors are parallel, then the cross product of those two vectors will be 0. On the other hand, x cap cross y cap equal to z cap, y cap cross x cap equal to x cap, and z cap cross x cap equal to y. All right? Similarly, y cap cross x cap equal to minus z cap. Okay, so because this does not have the A dot B is equal to B dot A, but A cross B is not equal to B cross A, because now we are dealing with a vector. In the component notation, A cross B is equal to the value of this determinant. Okay, the first row is I cap, J cap, J cap, so that's the direction. Second row is the components of A, and the third row is the components of the vector. We find out the value of this determinant and we get the cross product of vectors A and B. These are the two formulae that you need to keep in mind in relation to the vector or cross product of two vectors. Alright? Geometrical interpretation of cross product. So suppose these are the two vectors A and B. Okay? If you draw the parallel of them, then if you draw perpendicular from the tip of B onto A, then this height of the triangle is B sine theta, right? So in the parallelogram PQRS, B sine theta is the height. Then A cross B magnitude equal to AB sine theta is equal to height into base, because magnitude of A is the base and B sine theta is the height. So height into base, which is the area of the parallelogram. And direction is given by the normal to the plane of it. So direction would be like, you know, projecting out of the computer screen or the mobile screen, whichever you are looking at this presentation from. So when you take the cross product of two vectors to get the area of the parallelogram whose sides are formed by these two vectors, and the direction is given by the normal to the plane containing the two vectors. So area with its space orientation may be treated as a vector. Okay. Similarly, you can have triple product. You don't need this in detail, but you know, for knowledge, triple product A dot B cross C, and the result is that of parallelogram. You get the volume of a parallelogram if you take the triple product, which is a scalar. Since you are getting a volume, so you can understand that this is a scalar. On the other hand, if you can get triple product of a vector, okay? However, since cross product is a vector, so x cross y is zero, but if you just change the position of the bracket, then you don't get it to be zero. So you must keep this in mind when you are dealing with the dot. In end today, when I upload the elements, I will also upload the sample numericals so that you can go through the exam numerical examples related to the portions that we just discussed. Since there was a break